टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट एन एक्यूट केस. सो द टाइटल ऑफ दिस केस इज नॉन सर्जिकल मैनेजमेंट ऑफ अक्यूट अपेंडिसाइटिस विथ इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड होम्योपैथिक मेडिसिन. इट्स अ केस रिपोर्ट. नेक्स्ट. द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज सेम एज द टाइटल. So here I would like to show that the non-surgical management of acute appendicitis, which is treated with individual homeopathic medicine. So here the patient presented with pain in the abdomen, a 45 years anxious woman presented with complaints of gradually increasing pain in right iliac fossa, aggravated by stretching, walking, any kind of motion. And ameliorated by flexing the knees and lying on right side. She's sensitive to warm weather and she had desire for drinking warm water. And the history, when it was taken, there was no significant obstetric and family past history, nothing was found. So on examination, I clinically examined this patient. So I could get McBurney's point tenderness, it was found, and other clinical signs like Rossing sign. Rossing sign is that when you press on the left side of the iliac fossa, patient experiences pain in the right iliac fossa. This is also a confirmatory sign for the appendicitis. And Dunphy's sign, this is also like when a patient coughs, there is a pain which aggravates or be pain in the right side of the iliac fossa. This was also confirmed. And another test, that is Markel test, which is also known as heel drop jarring. So this is pain while walking. Whenever she gets jerks, that pain got increased. So this is also a sign of peritoneal irritation. So all these signs were positive and I advised her sonography of abdomen. So before that, before sonography, these all were the differential diagnosis thought of. As the clinical examination was very clearly showing, it was an acute appendicitis, but still we have to think of other conditions, especially if in a female patient, right-sided salpingitis, right ovarian cyst or right urethral calculus, all these things, then along with the inflammatory bowel disease, diverticulitis and mesenteric adenitis, intestinal obstruction, these all also can be thought of in case of this patient. So investigations revealed that the sonography of abdomen and pelvis both was advised. It showed a peristaltic tubular blind ending non-compressible structure which was seen arising from the cecum. The measurement of this structure was 8 millimeter and there was a mild to moderate periappendicular fat stranding is seen in with inflammatory reaction of cecum with minimal collection of fluid in the right iliac fossa. Next. So looking at the sonography, the final diagnosis was acute appendicitis and the radiologist who did the sonography, he said the condition it may go in for complications, so you better go for surgery, he advised. Next. So this is the report of the patient. So this shows the measurement of the appendix. Normally it is 2.5 to 3 millimeter in length, but here it has become 8 millimeter along with inflammation of the cecum and collection of fluid in the right iliac fossa with mesenteric lymphadenitis. Next. So this is how the inflamed cecum you can see with the inflamed appendix and the collection of fluid in the sonography. Next. So now when you see this condition, acute appendicitis, the changes in the appendix and you see the location. Next. So the different directions of appendix, you can see the positions of the appendix. The most common position is the retrocecal type, which constitutes around 64%, and in this patient, it was coming from the cecal size, that is the pelvic type of position was seen, which is 32%. Next. So the totality of symptom, as the patient was having precise modalities, precise symptoms, so on the basis of acute totality, the following was considered: that the anxious patient was anxious with pain in the right lower abdomen, and the typical very much characteristic modalities were noted, which was aggravated by motion, by walking, by stretching, and this pain was better by lying on the affected side with sensitive to warm weather and increased thirst. So this was converted into repertorial language, and then the repertorized, the totality was taken and repertorized using HomePass software. And the final remedies after the repertorization, these three remedies were got: Belladonna, Bryonia and Marksol. Now considering the inflammation, collection of fluid, lymphadenitis, it goes in more for the psychotic miasm. So when you go to the remedy references, Nash mentions that the name of the disease doesn't make any difference. The patient feels greatly better lying still, and slightest aggravation by motion, Bryonia is indicated. And Dr. Fartak mentions that abdominal wall is very tender in appendicitis, which is better by lying on affected side, which is seen in Bryonia alba. And thus, considering the repertorial totality and materia medica differentiation, Bryonia alba 200 was started. So the final prescription was Bryonia followed by SL. So 19th morning sonography was done. 18th she had approached me. I told her to get the sonography done immediately. We started the medicine before that, and then the 19th, after taking 3 doses of Bryonia, she was much better. Then 20th it was kept SOS. So gradually the pain started decreasing, and then the Bryonia was kept SOS, and then finally it was stopped. So the repeat sonography was done, wherein it shows that the size of the appendix is 3.8 millimeter, and there was no evidence of mesenteric lymphadenopathy, and cecum was also normal, though no inflammatory signs. Next. So this is the after report. So this is how on 19th the sonography was done. And the repeat sonography was done in April, which showed the change in the size of the appendix, and the all inflammatory signs were regressed after the treatment with Bryonia. So as we all know, in acute appendicitis, when such cases come to us, we usually don't take such cases. It is referred for a surgeon. So here the patient was willing to continue with homeopathic medicine. So she was given homeopathic medicines, and most of the times what happens, even after the operation also, after the removal of appendix also, the patient will have some complications of that. And as per the literature, Bryonia alba, when the pain of appendicitis tend to aggravate by moments, and it is relieved by rest, lying on the affected side, which was very peculiar and very clear in this case. Even though the remedy is simple, but the disease is wherein the surgery is avoided. Surgery was prevented here. Next. So many a times we hesitate to prescribe in acute cases and work on the case. So as Dr. Samuel Hahnemann rightly said, nosological classification by Master Hahnemann, follow the principles, we can give rapid, gentle and permanent cure, so which is far better than ordinary school of therapeutic. In this case, it illustrates the potential benefits and utility of homeopathic treatment for acute appendicitis without any serious complications. So next, these are the references. I just went through the literature, research work done on the appendicitis and appendicectomy. Most of the times, you know, patient will have vague abdominal pain. It is not diagnosed. They just open the abdomen and innocent appendix is knocked out, actually. See, the appendix is considered as an immune organ as per the latest research. It harbors gut bacteria, which are required to maintain the bacterial flora. Nowadays, it is considered that the intestinal health is overall, it gives rise to an overall health of an individual. So I feel wherein the simple remedy, bryonia is very simple remedy, but the disease wherein it can be tackled with a simple remedy. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to present this case.